David Hurst reporting from Bulgaria there. Now, a pillow fight in the rain outside Bradford City Hall. That's probably got your attention. It's exactly what it's supposed to do.
Yes, in our regular update from the ITV Fixers, we meet a young woman from Bradford who's using the surprise and originality of the new flash mob craze to get across a powerful message.
My name's Mariam Ahmed, I'm 21 and I'm from Bradford. My ITV Fixers project is raising awareness about poverty. Not just poverty in the third world countries, but also poverty in England and specifically focusing on Bradford. Our project is a flash mob, which is a pillow fight taking place in Centenary Square. It's all about young people getting involved and just showing that they're all passionate about a certain issue and they want to be involved and do something about the issue of poverty. I became officially homeless at 16, however, I'd been through homeless issues from the age of 13. I've experienced poverty quite a bit through, obviously, being homeless and the issues that I went through. And it has been pretty dire at times, sometimes where you just feel like you can go down the crime route and it's a lot easier to actually get the material things that your friends are getting and everyone else is having. And now, actually looking back, I'm glad that I kind of stuck to going through my A-levels and sticking to the hard path, which it would have been a lot easier to obviously go down the routes of crime and Asperger's and whatever else, but sticking to it. And now a lot of my friends are going through similar issues where they're like, what can we do? So I now see myself as a mentor to them, because it is pretty much a downward spiral and it's a circle that you can't get yourself out of once you're in there.
And what we've decided to do is a pillow fight in the middle of Centenary Square. So people will be like, why is there a pillow fight going on?
During the flash mob, a group of young people start off by just having a normal pillow fight. There's a few of them together to start off with, and bit by bit, different people come in. So it looks organised, but it kind of feels random as well because you don't know who's getting involved, and it's quite spontaneous. And then at the end of these 2-3 minutes, these people that have been involved in this pillow fight spell out the word poverty, and then the P, the T, and the Y from the word poverty are removed to spell over. So the actual message is poverty over. There were guys from the ITV Fixers that actually filmed the event for me. It's going to be part of a viral ad which will go online, such as YouTube and social networking sites, and also potentially part of a DVD which I'm hoping to see if I can go into schools. I do believe that a lot of people within, like not even just Bradford, within England, feel that youth poverty is not an issue. And we need to kind of get through, because the young people are going to be tomorrow's leaders and they are tomorrow's generation. So if we're living in poverty and it's a downward spiral, what have we actually got to live for tomorrow?
Everyone's coming together to do it, if you get me. Like, none of us know each other, but we've all had a really good day and, you know, worked together and stuff, so.
Like, we're the future, so we're making a stand against it, so.
Yeah, it's good that they're giving young people a voice, because we usually just kind of get bypassed by everyone. And
it's a massive issue to kind of tackle. And the fact that it's not something that the following day it will be, like, resolved, it won't just disappear, but it's something that I am passionate about and I am going to continue to strive to fight for.
Well, ITV Fixers is all about young people getting involved with their community and improving their community. And for further information and your chance to get involved, you just have to visit itvfixers.com or call 0113 322 1400. It's a non-premium rate call and your network operator rates will apply from a BT landline. Calls from other networks may be higher and from mobiles may be considerably more. Please seek the bill payer's permission before you phone. Don't forget, lines close on the 28th of February 2011 at 5 p.m, so plenty of time to do it. Calls made after closing time, though, will not be answered, but may still be charged.